a warm-hearted person who loved me till the end. People let me tell you about me so much fun. Whether we're talking man to man, whether we're talking sun to sun, cause he's my best friend.
Conrad, what do we got going on here? What's in there? Oh my god. Dude. That's a fucking, that's a Dropbox, boys. Oh my god.
Yeah, we just set it in here to get some pictures. We know it's got to come out for paint, but Conrad just welded this entire case wrap, man. And she's in there, buddy. Oh my god, we've got us a transfer case, dead centered too. As you guys can see, center line's right off the frame there. And you actually, a lot of guys mess this up, you need to offset your case because the center of your case is actually like center. I know I'm repeating myself, but that center, I see a lot of guys that'll put their case wraps dead center, well that actually moves your box that way. And you got two different drive shaft sizes or lengths. But doing it this way, you know, oh yeah, a little something light.
If you just wanted to,
oh man.
Guess what, guys? I cheaped out. I went with a 12-inch instead of an 18. So the jack shaft that comes off of the transmission will actually have an angle on it heading into this right here. But in all reality, the way I look at it is a normal truck, a normal drive shaft coming out of a daily driver truck has an angle on it. So, I mean, we're really not doing anything different. Plus, that one, that truck over there with a way deeper subframe has a 12-inch box. But this one, I still set it just as low as the 18 would have sat. So, the drive shaft angles from the bottom of the case to the axles are still going to be pretty minty. And she's got 2-to-1s in her right now. I bought this case from John. I think I might change it to a 1-to-1. I don't know yet. So we are doing a 12-valve motor and some type of automatic transmission. And I just don't want to mess up shift points. So 2-to-1 might be just a little too low because we're already at 23-to-1 at the end of that hub. So, you know, that's the point when you do a hybrid is you're taking the load off of the chunk in this case with doing your planetaries. So we might switch it to 2-to-1s. Or 1-to-1, straight case, straight through gears. But yeah, hope you guys enjoy. Here we are on a random Thursday. We have got Chris stacked some dimes today. Oh yeah, we are fully four linked everywhere. So Chris got those dialed in, fully welded. And now we are tackling something I dreaded, which was pulling apart this old power steering pump, which ironically I didn't have to pull apart, but we are utilizing the stock mounting of it for our orbital. And then our steering column will bolt onto here, and our stock steering shaft from our cab head right back to its place at the steering wheel. So yeah, we just used some 316s. If anyone has a Ford, 99 through 16 should be the same. Yeah, but if you guys have a Super Duty, I can make these if you're doing orbitals on, you know, if you're doing, that's how you're doing your steering. But that's how we did it. So we'll check back in when it's fully welded. Yo. So here we are in the cutting room. This is Taylor's subframe. And the cool thing about Taylor's old truck is I found the entire frame online, so. We're doing his main hoops right now, which are out of DOM. I think that's going to be our specialty now. The rest of the frame will be out of schedule pipe, but for the main hoops, we like to do them out of DOM. And like I'm saying, I think that's going to be our standard now for clean concepts. But he has made his two bends. We always get nervous doing this because this is not cheap tube. This is not pipe. If you look, That is quarter inch wall and there is no seam. This is true tube. And I'm just getting video evidence for him, so whenever he sells this, he can send them the YouTube link to show them that it wasn't scheduled. Matching this tab right here. So we went ahead and cut this out of some thin metal just to get us lined up. And honestly, guys, Taylor's truck is, his frame is probably gonna come out a lot more classy than mine, because mine was the test dummy, and his is gonna be probably perfect. So minimum crushing of the pipe. A lot of guys, you'll see, they'll fill them with sand or something so it doesn't get a kink in this bend. But honestly, man, it barely kinked it.
Yeah, barely.
And some guys don't like it. Some, for me, I could care less, and I don't think Taylor cares, because either way, it's 2-inch DOM. It's not going to break, so...
He's creaking.
Oh, man. It's going to be such a classy truck. Mirror image, baby. Chris was a huge help. He did a lot of welds because Conrad, our other welder, is out sick. But as you can see, our steps, and we've got support right there. I'm gonna cut some caps for this. Right, Shadow? All right, guys, haven't been filming much. So you've been crunching on this little girl. We just pressure washed her as good as we could. And we are getting ready to lay down some paint. Well, boys, we just wet the floor a little bit and got the frame up off the ground, and Taylor is gonna be a mixologist today. And she's ready to spray as clean as we're gonna get her. All right? Oh, look at that beautiful sight right there. So we made a little, well, I did a solo journey to go get CM28L26s. They're pretty decent. They got 26-28s, but we're gonna use my shells right there, the yellow ones. Yeah. Look at John's getting out of the camera quick. The only L I'm taking this year is right here.
Look at that. What's that say?
Alright, Charlie's gonna find.
So I just painted this whole frame?
Oh, yeah, yeah,
No, shout out to Taylor. I'm just touching up a few spots here. Trying not to mess up any of his work.
I'm no painter, but it's not bad.
Oh, it looks good.
It's, I mean, it's fine. I feel it in my eyebrows and my eyelashes. Get down in that hole, boy.
I gotta hold this can upright. That's the problem.
Oh, yeah, we missed a spot over here, too.
Where?
Yeah, can you tell who's actually been painting here?
Not me.
Not this guy. Oh, yeah, my shoes. Oh, yeah. The floor is black. Tracy over there, Tracy and John. Tracy's gonna murder us in our sleep, probably. Oh god, my hair.
Taylor's working on the scrap money truck. Logan's, you know, doing Logan things.
I'm a manager, dude. I'm managing.
He is the supervisor. But John is the big boss.
Yeah, he's our boss.
Yes. But now, guys, we've got the frame drying up, man. We just tossed the axles under her. Oh my god. I need to get the cover photo for this video, boys. Dang, dude. Yeah, how do you feel about it, man?
Hey, I'm ready, man.
He's ready.
I'm thinking
Logan's just
crunch, man. February.
He's on crack, man. We'll make March. We're gonna try and make March, man. But this is pretty awesome. So hybrids are under her. She's fully painted, glossing over beautifully. Taylor did amazing painting. I'm not gonna take any credit for spraying a gun. This dude right here laid it down, so. He's a mixologist and he's a painter, man. That's all we know. Got them HMF brake kits, HMF steering manifold. Then we got our Wild One custom steering rams, and the rest is all us. We did it right here in the shop, so that's what we do. Well, boys and girls, we've got our dummy big shocks on right now. It doesn't matter. I'll get it powdered. I ain't worried about it. Yes, sir, baby. Oh, man. We're up. The boys had me scared for a little bit, but we've got our dummy shocks in right now, dude. Very cool. Link bar is going down this week. Right?
Correct.
So we're gonna end this video here, guys. Just wanna get it to paint. Next video will be dropping very soon, but hope you guys get the picture now. We're gonna try. We're gonna give her our best shot.
Is that a bottom bolt trying to back yourself out there a little bit?
What bottom bolt?
Over there. On that
bar. He's scaring me right now. I have nuts on all of them, so.
I'm pretty sure it's like an 8-inch.
Oh, okay. Yeah, don't you worry about a damn thing.
I don't worry. I'll let you do the worry.
Yeah, you let me worry. But guys, I just want to say a big shout out to anyone that's still watching this content. Check out Mega Truck Media on Spotify. This guy's been on it.
Co-host boy.
We haven't got Taylor on it yet, but we got to get him on it.
I'm a busy man.
He's building a truck of his own. So, but yeah, this is how far we are. Check you guys. Check in later.